Hey everyone, I hope you guys are doing great and safe most importantly. As of now, we all are under quarantine and I was getting bored at home alone, so I decided to make a game which I can play with myself because I don't have any friends. So I made this rock, paper, scissor game. It works. So, in this video tutorial, I will show you how I made this. This video is sponsored by JLCPCB. From them, you can order your PCBs only for $2. Just upload your Gerber files to their website and then you can choose any color solder mask for the same price of $2. Which is sweet. They offer service for 2-layer, 4-layer and 6-layer PCB. You can also order your SMD stencil along with your order. Now they have even started the PCB assembly service only for $7. So click the first link in the video description to learn more. So the first thing we need to do to make this project possible is to detect the hand gesture or motion. So there are 3 gestures in rock, paper, scissors, which is rock, paper and scissor. So for that, I could have used a Raspberry Pi and made a machine learning algorithm and made my life difficult. But I'm a lazy person, so I decided to go an easy way. So for that, I used an Arduino, and to detect the motion, I used a simple IR sensor. But how does it work? This is the IR sensor which we'll be using in our project. So this thing has 3 pins, VCC, ground and the output. VCC connects to the 5V, ground to the ground, and output we will connect it to the digital pin of the Arduino. So we can detect the data. So the way this thing works is really simple. When the object comes between the sensor or in front of the sensor, it detects the output and the output falls to the low. By default, the output will be high. So this is really simple to detect using the Arduino. So let's first see if it works. So I just finished programming the Arduino and I have programmed it in such a way that if IR sensor detects something in front of it, the LED on pin number 13 will glow. So now if I put my finger in front of the IR sensor, the LED glows. So it works. So now that thing is done, we need to make arm-like structure for our Arduino. Now Arduino is not human, so it doesn't have arm. So we need to make one. So make that kind of mechanical structure, we will use this. This is a tiny servo motor used in RC planes or something similar. So this thing has this tiny arm which rotates according to the signal given to it. And you can hear the sound it makes. So this thing has 3 inputs, VCC, ground and the signal. Now I won't go into much detail how does this thing work. You can visit my website for that. And we will connect 3 of these and each one will have its individual arm, so stone, paper and scissor, and we will define a particular number to these 3 servo motors, so 1, 2 and 3. And the way it will work is when the object is detected, or I should say my hand, so a random number will be generated and using that number we will select the which servo motor will be activated. So I hope I made sense and I will show you the final results. So the programming is done and this thing works. So now if I put my hand in front of the sensor, any random motor will be triggered. So here is 1, 2, 3. You can see when I put my hand in front of the sensor, any random motor is getting triggered. Sometimes it does trigger the 2 motors, but that is due to the inaccuracy of the sensor. It can be adjusted by the potentiometer available on the IR sensor and it's a really simple fix. So this project is almost complete, I should say kind of, because it honestly looks kind of a mess right now. Now, if you want any more information about this project, code, schematic or anything, you can visit my website, link is in the video description. And now I have designed some 3D model case for this thing and 3D printed it. So enjoy the time lapse. After soldering and assembling everything, I uploaded the code to the Arduino Nano and tested it, and everything worked as expected, as you can see. After which I printed these hand gestures on a piece of paper and using tape stuck them on one side of this bamboo stick. And using hot glue, I glued the other side of the bamboo stick to the servo motor's arm, and this project was complete. And it works surprisingly well, as you can see. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed this project as much as I did. If you have any more suggestion, how can I improve this project, or what should I build next, leave them down in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the next one.